Can you believe that with just an old Coca-Cola can lid, you can make a super cool DIY welder machine? Yo, everyone. Today, I'm going to show you how to make a homemade welding machine with just a few batteries, some wires, and a bit of creativity. You'll have yourself a mini welding tool for small DIY projects. Super cost-effective, eco-friendly, and incredibly fun. Let's explore how to make it, how it works, and try welding a few items right in this video. Don't forget to hit like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell so you won't miss any of my next creative ideas. Let's get started. First, I'm going to grab two empty soda cans and carefully remove the pop-top lids. These little pieces might look like trash, but they're actually the key components for our DIY welding tool. So don't throw them away. We're about to turn them into something surprisingly useful. This is just a regular paintbrush, but I'm going to repurpose it as a handle for our DIY welding tool. It's got the perfect shape and grip, making a great fit for our project. Sometimes, the best parts come from the most unexpected things. I'm going to remove the bristles from the paintbrush so I can use just the handle. We don't need the brush part. What we're after is a sturdy wooden grip, which will work perfectly as a handle for our homemade welding tool. Now I'm going to mark two spots on the handle where I'll drill holes. Watch the video until the end and let me know which method you like the most. I'm really looking forward to hearing from you. I'm going to use these two screws to attach the soda can lids onto the handle. They'll hold the metal pieces firmly in place, forming the core of our mini welding tool. Time to lock it down. I'll use a drill and a couple of screws to firmly attach the lids to the handle. Nice and solid, just the way we need it. Next, I'm going to drill a hole for the handle so I can run the wire through it. This will help keep everything neat and make the final build look more organized and professional. Let's move on to the wiring. This is where things start to get interesting, connecting the power source to our homemade welding tool. I'm going to take two wires and thread them through the hole I just drilled. You should choose a thicker copper core wire to avoid using thin wires, as they can overheat and cause power loss. You can adjust the temperature yourself by changing the wiring or adding a resistor. It's super flexible for small welding tasks. Since this is a mini welder machine, thick electrical wires aren't necessary. Now I'm going to connect the wires to the two screws. These screws act as terminals, so make sure the wires are tightly secured to ensure a good electrical connection. I'll use this type of wire, and it will work just fine. The key is to secure the connections and properly insulate the contact points to prevent electrical leakage. I'll connect the other end of the wire to the welding tip. Wrap electrical tape around it to secure the wire. Now I'm going to wrap some electrical tape around the wires and the handle. This helps secure the wires in place and adds an extra layer of safety while using the tool. These are two tire valves, and I'm going to use them as the base to hold the welding tips. They're small, sturdy, and perfect for this kind of setup. Its design is both convenient and makes it easy to attach the soldering tip. I'm going to take them apart and insert them into holes on the soda can lids. These will act as the mounting points for our welding tips. Now I need a soldering tip. These are old batteries, and I can repurpose the graphite rod inside to make a soldering tip. The graphite rod is a good conductor of electricity and has a high melting point, making it suitable for use as a soldering tip. I will disassemble this battery to extract the inside part. I need to sharpen one end to improve the welding contact point. Now I will attach the graphite rod to the plug. I'll connect one end of the wire to a battery clamp. This clamp terminal is usually designed with spring clip or screw tightening mechanism, making it easy to attach and remove without complex tools. Now, let's prepare a motorcycle battery. It has a voltage of 12V, which is enough to power this welding machine. Connect the red wire to the positive terminal and the blue wire to the negative terminal. Before welding, I'll preheat the soldering tip. It's super hot. Now I'll test it with two razor blades. Wow, it works so well. It heats up quickly, creates clean welds, and operates smoothly without any interruptions. Let's test it with aluminum foil. a total success. After testing it with razor blades, the results exceeded expectations. Fast and strong welding, a well-deserved success. What do you guys think? Do you like this idea? Don't forget to leave a comment and share your thoughts. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.